Really looking forward to playing this character again and answering some questions that might have been asked in you through the years. Straighten some things out. So I can't say much, but I can say I just can't wait for y'all to see it. I start shooting it in about a week, and I'm just thrilled to be back. And you know, getting to play with the boys again and see the crew, you know, who we've all become friends with. It'd be great. It'd be like homecoming. Thank you so much.
Follow-up question?
Yeah, the guy in the pink shirt.
Thank you.
Or maybe it's rouge.
Let's go with rouge.
Burgundy.
Do you think you'll get emotional when you go into your trailer and you open the wardrobe and you see that old robe just sitting there? That could be a moment?
Yeah, for sure, that'll be a moment. Yeah. And then they'll be like, you're not wearing that. We just, you know, just got to cover the actual outfit. Yeah, I can't wait. I wonder if it's still around. I wonder if it's still there.
It's probably in the Smithsonian. They have to go check it back out.
Put on the wife beater.
Next to Fonzie's jacket. That's awesome. Super excited to get going back. It's really, really cool. And he won't tell me anything about it. And I see Rob, you know, several times a week as we work on various projects. And he mums the word with this guy. Seriously. National secrets.
Yeah.
Well, unbelievable.
You know, they hurt me. Worse than you.
Physically, not emotionally.
You just emotionally damaged me, yeah.
Exactly. All right, you.
Hi. So I'm normally all about asking the cast serious questions about their careers and stuff, but I always really enjoy watching you guys turn certain questions into comedy bits. So my question for you guys, all three of you, is if the world of Supernatural was a high school, what would the superlatives be, and who would be voted what? But there is one rule. Gabriel is not allowed to be voted class clown because that's very stereotypical and I'm a little sick of it.
Yeah, ditto.
Okay, so we're doing superlatives. We're in high school. It's the yearbook or whatever, and you go, most likely to.
Right, so I guess Sam gets best hair.
Right. Jensen, most likely never to use a verb.
Most likely to have a cannonball fired between his knees.
Most likely to be comedy elbows.
Jared would also get most likely to hit his head through every doorway he walks through. I think Matt would be voted most likely to grow up and get a job on a soap playing a sexy turtle.
Totally. What do I mean?
Shepherd would get most likely to grow up and be extremely pleasant.
I'm like, well, we didn't get them all, man.
Shepherd got friendliest.
Yeah.
I think you obviously would have gotten most likely to be God. I mean, you fit this character. So and clearly, I would have gotten most likely to work in porn. So there you go. Misha would have gotten most likely to always be prepared for a rainstorm. Or most likely to become a flasher.
I honestly, if we're in high school now, I vote Misha like most likely to eventually become some sort of politician or like leading a group of people to save the world. I mean, what he's done with Random Acts is pretty remarkable.
He really is our cast's Ted Cruz. You're right.
I don't want to talk about your candidate anymore.
I'm telling you.
Hey, Rich.
You should see Rob's tattoo.
I also think... such a jerk. I also think you'd be like to be bossiest. Like, you could literally be someone's boss. Because I imagine you in high school, you ruled the roost. Weren't you like...
Hey. I may or may have not been president of my school.
There you go.
But I did it with charm. I ruled with charm.
Sure, but you ruled.
But I ruled. but stuff went down the way it's supposed to go down, or else. Thank you for the question.
The girls.
Ruth would be most likely to be Scottish.
Yeah. Kim, most likely to have the most tattoos.
Spattering of booze.
You really point out my bad jokes. You can't really get me going, kiddo. all swing, you know, we can't all be over the fence. You know what I mean? Sometimes you ground out. And you're like the coach in the dugout. Denver, you swing too soon. Come on, you can do better. Pick it up. It's game. Come on, ready. Game time.
Trickster.
Elena, what would Elena be?
Hold on, Trickster slash Gabriel slash Loki would have been most likely to grow up and make fun of the guy who plays God slash Chuck.
What about Felicia?
Felicia. Most likely to be the cutest nerd on the planet. And by cute, I meant hottest. And by hot, I mean sexiest nerd.
Oh, bro, you got it. Brianna? Buckmaster?
Best singer.
Yep.
Best singer. She could be class clown.
Most likely to look super sexy eating donuts.
Most likely to dethrone the king.
Osric.
Osric. Most likely to crossroads?
Yeah, most likely
to
crossroads.
Most likely to decapitate the tall guy?
Yes.
Oh yeah, most likely to take Jared down.
Most likely to ninja chop that
SOB.
Bobby.
Sebastian, most likely to go to jail for inappropriate sexual behavior.
Most likely to spend time in a Turkish prison.
And enjoy it.
And enjoy it.
You, your turn.
Hi, my name is Jasmine. I'm from Memphis, Tennessee. And this is a question for Richard. And the episode, Just My Imagination, with this. The scene where Sam confides in Sully about what he thinks God wants him to do, with one of the best scenes ever so far in this series.
Thank you.
And what was it like to direct that scene?
That's interesting you asked that question. I'm super happy the way that scene turned out. And it turned out that great because Jared's a fantastic actor, is why that scene works. And we were fortunate enough to be able to partner him with a fantastically talented guest star in Nate Torrence, who played Sully. Unbelievable. And you know what? As one of those scenes where I did less is more. There's a very specific design to that scene. And you know the scene she's talking about? It's the scene where they're in the Quonset hut, sitting there talking about Jared's confessing to Sully what God wants him to do. And I specifically made Jared smaller than Sully. I seated him on a low chair and I seated the other guy on a higher perch. Because obviously Jared is an actor, he's a big guy, and he's always up above, and that's a powerful position to be. But being shorter than somebody, being smaller than somebody, and looking up to them creates a sense of vulnerability. And I felt like it gave Jared the opportunity as an actor to be very, very vulnerable to somebody with whom he had connected as a child. And he would immediately reconnect to those old emotional bonds he had had with Sully years ago when he was alone with him in a hotel room. So Jared and I talked about that at great length. I talked about this design and this idea that I wanted to pursue. He was not only 100% behind it, but had ideas that made it even better. And that's how we shot the scene. And I did minimal camera work in that scene because I felt like the performance would carry the day. I did a very slow push in on Jared while he's telling that story, and it was just beautiful work. It was just one of those things where, you know, Nate killed it. We shot Nate's angle first. It did this, you know, sort of tableau imagery from the front as a master, and then covered Nate, came around to cover Jared, and I just said, buddy, do your thing, you know, and I'm gonna move the camera when it's time. And we just did a slow push on it as he's looking up to Nate and getting choked up. I got choked up. So I'm watching the monitor. I'm like, oh boy. So like we're done. I'm like, I'm good with that. We're good. Yeah, moving on. Are we good? Are we good? I mean, Jared just killed it, man. I mean, and he is so in tune with the emotional journey of his own guy. That's not a, no director can direct No director can direct Jared Jensen. They know their characters much better than anybody who steps into that chair for a brief period of time. Those are those, they build, those characters belong to them. They own them. But they are also incredibly gracious artists who welcome suggestions and will work on ideas that they think help improve and or augment their interpretation of what a scene is. So I was very blessed that Jared, I was very blessed to get a script written by Jenny Klein that I thought was very, very poignant and heartfelt and had a lot of honest truth to it that I could play with. And I was blessed to have both Jared and Jensen be so gracious and willing to work with me on making it what I saw in my head. And they were just so great. They were so fantastic to work with. We make jokes a lot about they prank this, they prank that, but the fact of the matter is these guys do this 12 hours a day, 5 days a week for 11 years, and they do it at such a high level. And they are so good at what they do. They are prepared, they're gracious, they're talented, and they just swing for the fences every time. And I was blessed to be on that field playing ball that day for a great moment. Thank you for the question. Man, I was choked up. Oh, it was a mess. I mean, Jared killed that scene. Lord have mercy.
Hi, my question's for Ron.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm a huge music fan and a huge Loudon Swain fan.
Awesome.
And
he's in Loudon Swain.
I know. I noticed on the newest CD, Skylive, Crooked Wheel, you have a guest vocalist.
Yes.
And it was a familiar name to me. One of my favorite bands is King's X.
King's X, yeah.
Is it the same Doug Penny?
It is the same Doug Penny.
Do you know him? Are you friends?
Yeah, Billy is friends with him. Billy, our guitar player, you know? Is friends with Doug from like back in the day.
Awesome.
And yeah, and he was like, I wonder if we could get Doug to sing on this. And we're like, dude, that would be epic. You know, not everybody knows King's X or knows Doug, but the people that do, like Rich, love King's X. Like,
awesome.
It's just, yeah, they influenced a lot of other, you know, rock bands at that time. Anyway, so Doug was like, yeah, I'll do it. I was like, oh my God. And we were recording, at that point, we were just recording overdubs at the studio in my house. So he came over. It was crazy. And then after he's like hung out, I was like, is that Doug Penny from my house? It's awesome. So yeah, it was really, and when he did the tape, we were like, I mean, he's got, I mean, it, honestly, I imagine it'd be like when to be in the booth with like Eddie Vedder or Bono or someone like that. We're like listening, sitting right next to him where he's belting this song out. And we were just blown away. He was like, that wasn't really good. I could do it again. We're like, that was amazing. Like, we were freaking out. So yeah, it was a big deal for us.
Awesome.
Yeah, thank you so much.
I love that she knew that.
Yeah, I love it too.
Because I picked up on it. I was saying, that guy was great. He was that guy. And he's like, well, he's from a band called King's X.
King's X! I love King's X.
So it's cool that people know that because that's a great song. And might we hear that song tonight?
Yes, we're blessed to have our own Stephanie Dizon sings Doug's part. And we will be playing that live tonight.
I love it.
This side.
Hey guys.
Hi guys.
So I was wondering what your most awkward fan encounter was.
Awkward fan encounter? Rich?
What was my most awkward? I'll tell you what awkward fan encounter. A young man wanted a selfie in the bathroom.
Yeah.
So selfie etiquette, kids.
Yeah.
Not while people are otherwise engaged.
Yeah.
Save it for right outside the bathroom,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's hard to turn around and say no.
Yes.
When you've got to face a certain direction.
Yeah.
Matthew?
I once had a person's mother ask me to take her daughter's virginity.
Wow. That's crazy. And that never happened for me.
And the thing was, the thing was, as soon as it was over, she just was like totally regretful about it.
No,
too soon.
Didn't happen.
I'm kidding. I did not have sex with somebody's daughter, but I honestly was asked. A mother came up with her 15-year-old daughter. I wasn't 33 at the time. I was maybe like 25 or 26. Her mother came up and with her daughter, like arm in arm, and.
That's super creepy, man.
And you know what I said? No, but can I have your phone number? kidding. Again, it's too soon. No, so that was.